Entrepreneur running a business, please, I urge you, you can be able to learn things to do with innovation, things to do with mutation.
Hamjambo, great people. Yes, this is another exciting day. Now, I think for the last Fridays in Yatumekua, we love outdoor because outdoor are one of the best shows. And you guys, Nyindi Omunasemanga, when you are outdoor, we make you even feel like you are with us wherever we go. Karibuni sa, it's yet another good Friday where we are ready to inspire you. We have so much that is in store today. So, karibuni sana popote mlipo. And one interesting thing that we must mention, that God has kept us alive. Na before niendelee sana, allow me to introduce our able mentor. Na tuko tayari kuwapatia the best of the best. And we are super, super excited and super ready. And he is none other than anajitanga servant. Na ukiona ameinamilia hapo juu ni vitu tu anatengeneza. Sasa zingine nakaanga mimi ndio chairman hapa hivi. But karibu sana.
Asante DJ.
Unajua salamu zilisha?
Kwanza I sanitize you.
It's very important.
Yes.
Such times we must wash our hands. Mm-hmm. And very important. Any time.
Yes.
Anywhere you need to do that.
I tell you.
Yes, and thank you very much.
Thank you, DJ.
Yeah.
Wow. Thank you, DJ. Mm-hmm. And we welcome all our viewers, all our followers. Mm-hmm. And today we're going to discuss how we can give them a boost, mm-hmm. especially in their career, mm-hmm. in their business, and in their families.
And that is our topic today. Our topic today is how to thrive in business, career, and family in this season. But today, as we talk how to thrive in business, those are three areas that we need to talk about. First of all, let's start with business. What are the opportunities that we have?
Well, thank you, DJ Covenant, and our viewers. And this particular time during this season of this pandemic, mm-hmm. now we are calling it this thing. We are not even calling it a name. Mm-hmm. It has given us a lot of opportunities that we were not aware of. Remember, the globe was running quickly, and I think God saw that we are going to crash. Mm-hmm. This thing has slowed the world down. You know, there's a slowdown. Mm-hmm. And I'm so happy that I have been talking to some entrepreneurs, some business people, and they are saying that, George, I think we are able to discover the opportunities that have come up because of this particular pandemic. And one of the things that I was talking to a friend of mine says that the factories have woken up. You know, people manufacturing textile. You know, everybody requires this thing. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. these are opportunities. There are people manufacturing these things. You know, some are African orientations, others are different orientations. Some are branding. You know, I saw the other day I went to Panarottis. Mm-hmm. Theirs is written Panarottis.
Wow.
I went to the spa. Uh-huh. Theirs is written spa. So the opportunities coming up. And other than those ones, of course, families have got time to stay together. Mm-hmm. And other than that, you know, people in deliveries. You know, people with the piki-pikis, they are able to deliver things to people's houses. And of course, the ICT opportunities. You know, if there are people that are really busy, there are people doing ICT. They are automating, helping people to automate. Mm-hmm. Others are doing digital platforms, like people like, you know, Bonnie here. Mm-hmm. So there are opportunities opening up. And of course, the government, I saw the budget. The government is spending a lot of money during this particular time. Mm-hmm. And I'm happy to say that some of this money is going to manufacturing. Mm-hmm. A huge amount, you know, billions of shillings are going to infrastructure. That means when the infrastructure is being done, jobs are being created. So it is not all doom and gloom. So there are opportunities, there are doors opening. And I ask our people, open your eye to see, what are these things I can be able to do? DJ Covenant, you can check your eyes there. Mm-hmm. You know, that machine you see there whereby people are pressing on the, you know, mm-hmm. use your foot to press, mm-hmm. and then you are able to wash your hands. Uh-huh. That machine there, ile mtungi unaona pale,
yes.
na zile tushuma pale.
Yes.
A guy, a Kenyan guy discovered it. Today, he is selling thousands and thousands of these equipment.
Wow.
And the other people are also selling PPEs, personal protective mm-hmm. equipment. Mm-hmm. They are making money. So don't stay there at home and say, businesses are down. You need to think, which other opportunities are coming, especially the traditional way of doing things. We mm-hmm. need to change that.
Excellent. We can move on with our topic. Mm-hmm. Are there more areas that we can look into when you're going into business?
Let me say that DJ Covenant, remember, our people have got businesses going. Mm-hmm. Some businesses literally closed down, mm-hmm. including the GMC. We had literally closed this particular facility. Mm-hmm. They had closed this
yes.
facility.
Yes.
And even as we had closed our office in the town, mm-hmm. and there are many people who are watching us, because government said you have to work from home. So everybody went to work from home. So there are people who are watching us and they have been ailing. They have been suffering because they have no cash flows. They have loans to pay. They have salaries to pay. So we are not ignorant that businesses have really facing some challenges. But we want to discuss this particular show. How can we come out? How can we thrive? How can we be visible that we are able to start operations once more? And I'm so happy that God has been faithful to Kenya, faithful to Africa. Because somebody prophesied, I think, from another country I won't mention, and says that they are going to collect Africans dying on the streets. But God loves Africa. Wow. Remember, Jesus Christ was saved by Africa, came to Egypt. And we thank God that we have been taken care of by God. So we thank God for that. So those who are running businesses, this is not time to give up. I'll give you three strategies on how you can thrive in your business. And one of them, if you are running this particular business, remember, you are the leader. You are the priest of your business. You are the pastor of your business. So you need to offer leadership. So don't coil down when others are coiling. So have time to think and encourage the people you work with. Encourage the customers that you deal with. Talk to your landlords. Negotiate rates. You know, show leadership. You know, leadership is about thinking away from the box. And once the leadership is good, the people that you lead, they are also going to follow. Somebody said, John Maxwell said, wherever the leader goes, the organization follows. So you who is running a business, wherever you will go, the business will follow you. Number two, as a leader, and somebody, entrepreneur running a business, please, I urge you, you can be able to learn things to do with innovation, things to do with mutation. Can you mutate your business? Yesterday, I was talking to a friend of mine and says, he was running a tour farm, and all his vans are lying idle. Then ask him, why can't you remove these seats over this tour van? And this tour van can be a mini supermarket. Wake up Mananasi Pale, come to Kitengela, open that boot and sell these pineapples. You can also sell eggs. So it's about mutating. And I'm so happy that some of our suppliers who used to do print work for Optiven, nowadays they are supplying these things. They are supplying a mask. They are supplying PPEs. Why? Because as a leader, you cannot just wait when this COVID is going to end. We don't know how far it is going. And then number three, for you, for your business to thrive, please keep in touch with your customers, both internal customers and external customers, your employees or the customers that serve you. Keep in touch. Check on them. Call them up, because you never know. Tomorrow, you need them. And then finally, a bonus point. Keep your brand shining. Mention about your brand. Tell people that you still exist. Because that one, you'll put in customers' mind that GMC still exists. And that's why these guys, they are willing to host us. They are not opened, but they're saying, come, we host you. In anticipation that on 26th, they are opening. Yes, DJ Covenant.
Wow, excellent. I hope you're listening to this, because these are very important points that you need to note. So let's talk about careers.
Yes.
In these times, how do we deal now with the careers?
Wow, thank you, DJ. There are so many people who are in career, and most of them, of course, they are home. They are either working 50% home, or some were actually terminated. And it's not the will of the employer to terminate. It's because there's no fuel called the cash flow. There's no cash flow. There are no customers. So there are people who are out there, and we also want to encourage them, to inspire them, that if you are at home, you know, there are some people who just, they have lost hope. It is not time to lose hope. It's the time to re-energize. It's the time to think, what else can I do? So three things that you can do. Find something to do. You can find a skill that you have been wanting to do, and now you have 24 hours. There's a guy I really like. This guy called Bonnie Tinder. The other day he sent me a certificate. So when he went home, of course he's working for Optiven half and half. Is at home.
Marriage certificate.
Yeah. So he sent me not marriage certificate.
Okay.
Neither certificate of polio.
Okay.
A certificate of a digital course he did online. He did it and sent a certificate. Pop! I said, wait a minute. I think this is what career people need to do. Wengine tu wanaka tu, they are just complaining. They are watching the wrong news. They are just waiting for the numbers. How are the numbers now? By the way, I don't care about the numbers. I don't even watch those numbers. This guy called Bonnie. Ye aligia kwa mtandao. And he did a course for about 3 weeks. Certificate came. So if you can do that, and you send that certificate to your employer, I can tell you, when people are being declared redundant, you won't be on the list of redundancy. Wow. Why? Because you are making yourself relevant. And that's my point number two, DJ Covenant.
Mm-hmm.
Make yourself relevant. Is there something you are doing for your employer that employer can see, oh, this guy called Nagilai, he's even doing FB Live.
Mm-hmm.
This guy is talking about the Optivian brand.
Mm-hmm.
I can guarantee you, I can tell you,
mm-hmm.
you are not going to be on the list of people who are going to be dropped. So if you are watching us, you are in career, you have a job, make yourself relevant. Please ensure that you are checking on your employer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the other day I was saying that who encourages the leader? Be the person to encourage your leader so that you make yourself come at the habu.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, the last one,
wow.
you know, check on what the government is doing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, check on the current status of what the government is doing. And then align your career with that particular agenda.
Mm-hmm.
The other day I was talking to some students from the university. I told them, I think even as you choose career, careers have changed. So the area to look forward to this particular time, our viewers, is the area of digital platform,
mm-hmm.
the areas of ICT, because now people have moved from offices. People are now doing their own small offices in their houses. They need support. They need ICT support. They need ICT equipment. They need to be sorted out.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the way to go.
Something that we love to talk about,
mm-hmm.
families.
Yes.
And I know you're very passionate about when it comes to families.
Mm-hmm.
In these times, they're also having challenges. They're also going through a lot in their life.
Wow.
Let's talk to them.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. And I'm happy that, you know, sometimes we get some reports and get a bit disturbed when we hear that the families are getting depression, they are getting stressed, others are fighting. And that's not very good, because when families are not stable, the country is not stable. You know, our counties are not stable. And for us, we always pray that there's a transformation, especially in families, whether single families, whether families with both parents, whatever the setup of the family, we require this particular piece. And I want to address the head of families, whether it's a lady or a man, as a head of the family. You have four P's, you know, four P's that you must practice for your family to stand. The four P's, P number one is you are the pastor of your family.
Mm.
So ensure that you pray for your family. Ensure you read the word of God for your family. Ensure that your family is attached to God. That is P number one. You are the pastor. P number two is that you must participate in family affairs. You know, let me talk to the fathers. You know, the fathers must participate on the welfare of the children. The fathers must participate in the kitchen. Enda kwa jikoni, pikia watoto samosa. DJ Covenant.
Mm-hmm.
And that participation, you bond. You know, you are able to come together, your children. Take on their homework. You know, you must participate. That's P number one. And of course, you know, as a family, be it a man or a lady,
mm-hmm.
we have responsibility to spread love.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they say that a home without love is not a home, because you start now fighting.
Mm-hmm.
How can you be able to exude this love to the family? Be there. Be there for the family. Don't be there and you're not there. There are people who are there, but they are not there.
Mm-hmm.
Because number one, they come to the house, they don't even speak. They come to the house, they don't talk to anyone. They come to the house, nivita too. Right from financial issues and other issues. And let me tell you, especially people who are younger in families, you can be able to make your family shine if you participate, you discuss issues openly without culling the things of yesterday. Because the things of yesterday destroys the things of today and the future becomes terrible, DJ Covenant.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Wow. But I find it very interesting because
yes.
it unites family.
Mm-hmm.
When you see your dad cooking,
yes.
sometimes it makes you, like as a child,
exactly.
you see that person as a mentor as well.
Exactly.
You're able to see something else that you didn't know.
But that is true because it has a positive move. Of course, DJ Covenant, I forgot to mention P number three.
Yes.
P number three is about positivity.
Mm-hmm.
So as the head of the family, you must be positive. The way you speak to your customers, the way you speak to your children, the way you speak to the people around your home,
mm-hmm.
let your words be positive words, words that really build. You know, there's something you can tell your child,
mm-hmm.
and that child becomes, you know, an afinika.
Mm-hmm.
So I think positivity in family setup is extremely good.
Mm-hmm.
Don't call your child a dog
mm-hmm.
or a donkey,
mm-hmm.
you know, or a horse.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a horse.
Mm-hmm.
It's a human being. And we can be able to change the environment of the family.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Wow, excellent. That was pin number three.
Yes, positive. Except
positivity.
Be positive.
Be positive.
Yes.
Always and everywhere.
Wow.
Any word that you would want, maybe unaweza kusema how that we need them to know?
I think for all our viewers, we must thank you, and we are happy that, you know, God has kept you, you know, even this particular period. God has kept you, has taken care of you. You are healthy, you are alive. And there are so many things that you can be able to thank God for. There's something I call the attitude of gratitude. Every day you rise up in the morning, you have things you can tell God that thank you. You can see, you can walk, you have energy. So don't just be a person of complaining, because complaining brings a lot of issues. Complaining brings sickness. People who get sick frequently, they are people who complain. The children of Israel, they were complaining and God was giving them manna. And you know the punishment. Don't be the person who always murmur. Don't complain about your employer. Complain about your family. See the good things that you have and say thank you for those particular things. When you say thank you for those particular things, DJ Covenant, other better things come. Mm-hmm. Can I tell you a secret?
Mm-hmm.
People who get promotion in their place of work, mm-hmm. they are those people who see the good part of the employer.
Mm-hmm.
But there are people every time, hata kita pale kwa jikoni, pale kwa kitchen,
mm-hmm.
their job is gossip. And nobody wants to be associated with gossipers. Nobody wants to be associated with people who always talk about other people. If you must talk about other people,
mm-hmm.
talk about the positive things.
Mm-hmm.
Tell somebody, hey, I'm so happy. Kevo bought a property in Victory Gardens Phase 3.
Mm-hmm.
Then talk about Victory Gardens. There are solar there, there are roads there, and people are settling. But don't say, Kevo bought a property in a dry place called Kitengela.
Mm-hmm.
That's why unaharibu. You know, see the positive aspect of life. And once you are positive, you attract positivity.
Mm-hmm.
And positive people, DJ Covenant, our viewers, they live longer.
Mm-hmm.
These
mm-hmm.
are the people who are Nagonga 100 years. Like the people who always make noise, people who are critical. Wakifika 50, wamezeeka. Wakifika 45. They are heading to the grave because they have nothing to offer in the world. The world is looking for something good, something positive, something that energizes people. The world is full of negativity. The world is looking, is attracting the positive vibe. Are you the kind of a person who spread the positive vibe? Be that particular person.